Saints, I am honored and blessed to minister to you from the Word of God again. As a dispenser of truth, I pray that the Holy Spirit will anoint these lips of clay that I may effectively articulate a Word of God to somebody in need today, that I can minister a Word of healing to somebody today, a Word of deliverance to somebody today. You see, we're living in a time where people are so used to listen to nice sermons or candy sermons that they no longer want to listen to truth. And Jesus said, it's the truth that will set you free. He doesn't say it's sermons that will set you free, but it's truth that will set you free. And I want to come and bring a word to you that I sense in my spirit is a word of truth that God want to help somebody today. I want to read with you from the NIV version, in the Epistle of 1 John chapter 4 and verses 18. It reads as follows. It says, there is no fear in love, but perfect love drives out fear, because fear has to do with punishment. The one who fears is not made perfect in love. Here we see that perfect love casts out fear, the King James Version says. Fear not is the most repeated commandment in the Bible. In fact, it has been said that fear not is been repeated 366 times in the Bible, including a leap year. Every day there's a word, fear not. God wants to remind us daily, every single day, that we do not have to fear. He wants to give us a word of comfort that we do not have to fear. This is coming from this words is coming from Saint John the Divine, and he was the disciple whom the Gospel of John described as a disciple whom Jesus loved. He was secure in the love that the Master was having for him, and he wrote these words: a perfect love casts out fear. You see, fear is the dark room where you develop your negatives. The Bible says perfect love. The word perfect here is the Greek word that can be translated to come to full maturity. When love comes to full maturity, it casts out fear. As the children of God, we have to get settled into the love of God. We have to know that God loves us in this time that we are living in, to be secure in His love. I don't know for who this message is, but I want to tell somebody listening to this that God loves you. He loves you because He loves you. He loves you because He loves you. The Bible says in Jeremiah 31 and verses 3, the Lord has appeared of old unto me, saying, I've loved you. Therefore, I've drawn you with loving kindness. That is, if we can get secure in the love of God, we don't have to fear. We don't have to fear for the new normal. We don't have to fear for what's going to happen. We don't have to fear for the future. People are struggling with fear and phobias, from social phobias to fear for the future. And I believe the Spirit of God wants to break that grip and that bondage of fear from people's lives, if we can know that God loves us. In fact, the Bible says in Romans 8 and verses 31 to 39, what shall we then say of these things? If God be for us, who can be against us? He that did not spare His own Son, but has delivered Him up for us all, how shall He not with Him also freely give us all things? Who shall bring a charge against God's elect? It is Christ who has died, and furthermore is also risen, who is at the right hand of God, who makes intercessions for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or peril, or sword? As it is written, for your sake are we killed all day long. We are counted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, but in all these things we are more than conquerors through Him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither life, nor death, nor angel, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor heights, nor depths, nor any other thing shall separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. Close quote. Now you see, that is the love that God has for us, and nothing can separate us from that love. So when we get settled and secure on God's love, that love will cast out all fear. And that is the word for you today, that God, that I believe that the Lord want to minister to you today. Just there where you are, I want to just pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that fear will lose its grip from your people. That you will set your people free in the name of Jesus, that they can know that perfect love, as John the Divine says, perfect love casts out all fear, that you will set your people free, that they can live with that security, not to fear, but to only believe during this time and during these challenges that we have. This I ask, Holy Spirit, I pray that you will touch somebody, that you will speak to somebody, that you will heal somebody today. Come and have your way. In the blood name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. God bless you.